Got an Australian story?
This country is such an inspiration.
Her family's been out here for years.
You know, you'd never see this anywhere else.
I felt I was falling.
It's a secret I've been keeping for my whole life. This reaches to the depths of my soul.
Learn from these wild animals of the bush.
Yeah, well, that's my Australian story.
Hello, I'm Caroline Jones. 3 years ago, Pauline Hanson exploded out of nowhere into public life, and she's seldom been out of the headlines ever since. She's won and lost a seat in federal parliament, built up a new political party, and right now she's watching it tear itself apart. Along the way, she's been parodied and pilloried to within an inch of her life, at some personal cost to family and friends, as you'll see shortly. But Pauline Hanson accuses the media of constantly distorting her motives, her message, and her personality. She's a woman of whom it can be said that everything and yet nothing is known. Australian Story has been filming with Pauline Hanson over the past few weeks in the lead up to and during her biggest crisis.
Titanic? Yes, I did. Yeah. It was a beautiful movie. Sorry. Don't slam it, just tap and leave the ball down here. Very good.
Pauline and I have known each other for probably 20 odd years.
If I said slam it, would she tap it? Okay, stop mucking around the show.
I first met Pauline when she moved next door to me. We were neighbours, had kids together, took them to school together, shopped together, did our baking together, used to make Anzac biscuits and fruit cakes and goodness knows what, that sort of thing. We just became very good friends and it's lasted.
No, it's right. Your turn.
The last 3 years have probably been the worst of her life.
She's copped a lot from the media, she's copped a lot from people who do not support her. There were times when myself, I got it, received a death threat and my brother was stalked, but we haven't actually received that much. Mum's always tried to keep us out of it, out of the limelight, and keep us out of it, which has helped heaps.
Can you hit the purple?
Yeah, no worries.
There's been a tremendous amount of negative press about Pauline over the past few years. Not only about her political experience, but about her own private life and her family life. And in particular, there has been a lot of negativity about the role she's played as a mother, portraying her as being a poor mother or not a caring mother, that type of thing.
That's my
fault. It affects me by seeing the way the media portrays my mother. It hurts me in the way that I know the truth, and when someone portrays my mother as being this, and it's not true at all, I say, why are they doing this? And I have to either look at it in the way of other people's eyes, or I can look at it strongly and just push it away, which I've done.
The story which they put in the paper these days, you're the news.
The sour-faced, I think you picked the worst bloody photo you could find.
Oh, I didn't choose it.
Oh, well.
I didn't
choose
it.
Well, who do I go to?
That was, I imagine that's the editor of the Pictorial Editors in Sydney. It wasn't a bad photo.
Oh, Adrian, come on, pull the other leg.
You look as if you were firm and you were sort of giving them
you put a perception across to people like, I'm this real hard-lined woman, and that's what the photo says. It doesn't portray the root behind the story.
Well,
you know, it's been hard, and it's a hard battle to actually beat the media. I don't know if I ever will be able to.
To me,
nothing's changed.
I thought it was a positive story.
I got another band pick with you.
Right.
I wake up sometimes and I see the pictures in the paper and I read the stories and I just feel like throwing my hands up in the air and I think, what for? They sit there,
They come to my meetings. They hear what comes from the heart. They know the reaction from the public. They misreport the numbers that actually come to my meetings. And then they say there's more protesters than what there are. They don't report that people are actually being spat on and abused. They don't say what I have to go through to get to these meetings. So people have the opportunity to listen to me, what I have to say. A racist and a bigot, and put across that I'm this uncaring woman. I'm standing up for people who have fought for this country, that we can hand on to a better country. I'm not trying to divide this nation. I'm trying to unite us and say we're all Australians. Treat everyone equally and the same, under the one law. Dad wasn't happy with me getting into politics, and he was concerned for me because I'm a single woman and with a couple of children, and I didn't need to get into politics because it was such a dirty game.
She's still dancing,
yeah.
Oh, isn't that wonderful? That's great. Well, I hope I can, at that age, still get up and have a dance.
You will if you're a politician.
He said, you will never change anything. And I said to Dad, I said, it's people like you with your attitude. I said, that's why nothing will ever change. I said, you'll never change anything unless you get out there and have a go. And I said, that's the old Aussie saying, have a go, mate. And I said, Dad, that's exactly what I'm going to do.
Gets tired of the abuse, and all she wants to do is make Australia better for her children. I suppose the main pain is of people not really noticing of what she's saying, not understanding what the point she's trying to get across to the people. When they put across the wrong point of view of saying that she's racist, she's doing the wrong thing for this country, when that, in matter of fact, they don't actually know what she's trying to do.
Revitalise Australian manufacturing. And the rural sector. Repeal the Native Title Act. Abolish ADSIC.
When she went up to Palm Island, she told me how the place, I mean, it could be a tourist resort, but it was just, it was so dirty, it was so untidy. You know, I could just see Pauline there saying, well, get out there and clean up that rubbish and get yourself dressed up and, you know, and take a bit of pride in your environment, take a bit of pride in yourselves. I think the worst thing for the Aboriginals is to give them money and not give them work, not give them something to do. We never got anything for nothing. We learnt from a very young age. You work and you get paid. The harder you work, the more you get paid. It's pretty simple.
Advance Australia,
nation. It's not against our mate.
Freedom of speech!
Freedom, freedom, just listen, that is it. I listened to it and I don't agree with what you said, but I went there and listened to it for a while and I walked out.
Actually speaking, I think he had, it's not a great word to use, but they all use it, a ton of guts to even stand. And but she said what most Australian people want to hear. Exactly. But nobody else was going to say it. As the old people would say, she must have a heart like a bullock. That's what they would say, you know.
Well, you want to put them back to San Diego or out? Do you want to let them go back out the paddock? Yeah. I said, you want to let them go back to the paddock?
Well, I've always found her 100% excellent. She's worked up here and helped me, and I've helped her do the fences on this property.
You want to put them through the crate, Pauline?
She uses this a hobby farm, but she does know quite a bit about those cattle. She's read it up, and she has that experience before. She's very good to work with. She's never lazy. She's right out in the front there to help you, always.
Heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
It is an amazing journey. It certainly is. And 20 years ago when we were just housewives talking about how the country should be and how the government should run the country, that sort of thing. It is an amazing journey from then to now.
Where are we eating?
Here or in there?
Just here.
The role I have with Pauline at the moment, I'm her personal assistant, which involves everything from secretarial work to arranging her diary, helping to arrange her itinerary.
Oh, would you like me a massage tonight? Because when I...
No, I'm not.
Oh, come on.
I do help out, stay with the children when Pauline's not home. Although they are teenagers now, they don't need looking after so much, but it's still nice for them to have someone around.
She was actually a bridesmaid at my wedding, matron of honour, so we do go back a long way. I suppose she's as close as what a sister could ever be. She's a person that knows me better than anyone could ever know me.
It's been just a huge learning experience all the way through for her. She's also had to cope with the adoration of the thousands of Australians who believe that she's doing the right thing. And these Australians are... A lot of them tend to put Pauline on a pedestal and feel that she's a saint, which is more than what Pauline thinks of herself. She gets masses of mail coming in daily, but a lot of the time she just doesn't have the resources and she doesn't have the time to respond to everything. There have been occasions when people have written or rung to ask for Pauline to visit as their dying wish, if you like. They may have had terminal cancer. Pauline has visited them in the last days of their lives, which has meant so much to them. But to me, that is really difficult to fathom because she's just Pauline to me.
Oh, it's either you love me or you absolutely hate me. So it's one extreme to the other. You'll be walking down the street, you don't know whether someone wants to hug and kiss you or whether they give you a smack in the mouth. I've got a lot to sort of wear, by all means, as far as that goes. But it doesn't change anything. I'm still Pauline Hanson, the woman. That's from a fish and chip shop, that's helped run a plumbing business, that's had a year 10 education, that's reared 4 children, and can scrub and clean and do gardening and knit and sew and cook just like any other woman. So I don't consider myself to be any different.
Please welcome Pauline Hanson and I'm here.
I suppose her aura is very, very hard to explain. It's unexplainable, actually. She's always stood out there upon every other mother I know. She's always actually stood out differently or shone like a bright light. And you hear people say, oh, it's really her, I can't believe it. It's just, and you think to yourself, well, it's my mum, whoa.
I'm very honoured to say that as my mother. I'm very privileged to have a mother such as the mother I have, and it makes me feel happy inside, and it gives me the edge, really, to go on and strive for what I believe, because Mum always told me, whatever you want in life, you have to get it yourself. If you want something that bad, you do anything to get it.
To be compared to Hitler, I suppose, would be about the most hurtful thing that's ever happened in my life. It is vile, it is disgusting that people would even try and, you know, compare me to Hitler. And I question them, what have I ever said or ever done that could ever relate me to anything what Hitler has done or ever said? They are disgusting.
One teacher, she was very protective of me when I received my death threat and tried to look out for me, but a lot of other teachers do not agree with my mum, which reflect onto me. History is a very touchy subject for the way I look upon things. It always reflects onto the way you write things, and it's supposed to be encouraged to say what we feel, when actually, as a matter of fact, I've been put down for what I've said, saying that that's not true. Some teachers do look out for you, so other teachers don't. They'd rather keep out of it. And some teachers, nothing but put you down for as they see you through your parents, which I think is wrong, as I'm an individual myself and should be seen for what I say myself.
The salt's here, guys.
Shall we have a tea? I actually have shares in the salt mines.
No.
Quick, you're going to empty that one, do you?
No, that's not.
She's often portrayed as being this very fiery person. She's very determined. She has got a strong point of view. But there is selective media reports which will only portray that small section and show her in a very poor light. She has a soft side, she has a hard side. But generally, they portray this negative, fiery, harsh person, which is not a true indication of what Pauline's like.
I had a lot of good response yesterday, but you didn't see that part. And there was nothing in here saying that I got a good response.
Prior to the federal election, there was media coverage with Pauline daily.
But no way in the bloody wide world am I going to allow the media make me lose it because of stories like this, which comes across so negative for the fact that people aren't interested in wanting to talk to me. And that's what that is to me, such a negative story, when it didn't really happen that way at all.
They were shooting and taking notes and recording everything throughout the whole day. Of an evening, there would be a snippet of maybe an 8-second grab or something, which would be a negative statement or something to portray Pauline in a bad light.
I don't know if it's your boss behind you that tells you, that says, right, we want something here that's going to put her down, have a shot at her. If that's the way it is, then please go away from me now. I don't need you.
There was nothing positive ever shown throughout that period.
Because I won't be happy if this comes out, because I said this is for the record, and I just don't want this.
What we sort of done?
Are you still taking photos?
I
didn't
take
photos. You know, when I speak to you like this and I say it's off the record, is it really off the record?
Yes, of course it is. Yeah, we're honourable people.
I was upset. I suppose I was more upset with the whole system, because it was the system that beat me.
Are we seeing the demise of One Nation here tonight?
But in my own heart, I know the majority of people in the seat of Blair wanted Pauline Hanson as their representative. The day after the federal election, I stayed home here and I woke up to have a barrage of media at my front gate. It was such an intrusion. It's like the vultures were back again to see what piece they could get of me again. Cheyenne was here and she was a godsend. She was the only one that was here for me. But yeah, I've picked up the pieces. I've had a good rest. And I'm moving on, and you look at the positives and you learn by your mistakes, and they're not going to beat me. Long red dress with a boa around it. I know, in different times I've been set up by the media.
And like I said, Australian made.
Yeah, that's right. That's what I'd like to write about with the song.
The classic example of a betrayal was when I did a media shoot on fashion, and I wanted to promote Australian made products. When I opened up that newspaper and read the story, I was just absolutely devastated, because I strictly said to quite a few people why I was doing the story. To actually read the story, that after they did the fashion shoot, they took the photos, went to different fashion consultants and people and said, would I make a good model? It had no truth to it whatsoever, because I wasn't wanting to be a model. I didn't want to particularly do the fashion shoot, because I'm not a model. I don't want to be a model. I am actually a politician. I know I've got no comeback. I can't do anything. I've got my hands tied. So what do? They control it. They actually control everything.
You didn't clarify to the readers what the vote was lost on.
Hey. I didn't write that story, but I know what the vote... Oh, yeah, sure. If that wasn't explained, you've got a good reason to complain. I don't like being on television. And you're used to it, I'm not.
Do you ever get used to it, really?
No, I don't think so. I'm sure you don't.
The table's turning.
Yes, I know. Hello, Cheyenne. How are you?
But journalists out there, oh, yes, they made me. Because here was this woman, big joke, who came from a fish and chip shop. They even some still refer to me as that. That she's come onto the scene. Well, she was news. She sold newspapers. So it was all this, we'll feed off her, we can make some money out of her. But now it's like in Australia, the tall poppy syndrome, that we'll only let you get so far, and then you start hurting the establishment, we've got to get rid of you. So we'll cut you off at the knees. So it's like a lot of the journalists out there with their own agenda, or being told by their bosses or all their editors, get her. Destroy her.
Pauline Hanson has run out of patience, demanding two wavering One Nation members swear their allegiance to the party or quit.
The events of last week were so devastating to me, I just couldn't believe what was actually happening. They've had enough time. Make up your mind. Where does your loyalty lie? I was ready to just pack up, go away. I'd had enough. And the only person that pulled me out of it was David Oldfield. So here's this man who gets criticised as if he's taken over,
and he wears that much flak that he does not deserve. He's the one. He's the only one. That's why I'm still here. He said, you can't let them beat you. We've come this far. He said, it's just another little hiccup. We've had this before, we've got over it. And he said, you can't. He said, you're not going anywhere. For Barbara Hazelden to make a comment in the media that I was in love with David Oldfield and I lost the comment is a complete and utter lie. I have a lot of time for David as a very, very good friend. But we have a working relationship, nothing other. And Barbara has no basis to make any comment on anything else saying that I was in love with him and he was controlling me. They are complete and utter lies.
The events of the last week have been hurtful. It has been really traumatic for Pauline. I've seen this last week take a toll on her. It has had an effect on her, but I know her. I know what she's capable of, and I know that she will bounce back. This isn't the end of her or One Nation. She's been saying to me she's determined not to let them defeat her. If they defeat her, it will be the end for Australia. She's not going to throw away everything that she's worked so hard for, and to sum it up, she says she will not let the buggers defeat her, and she won't.
It would be so easy for me just to turn my back and walk away. I would dearly love to have a life, to settle down and have my children around me without having the media probing into my private life, to settle down, to find someone I can share my life with. But I'm not prepared to do that yet. I'm prepared to fight on. And I just wish people would just give me the time to prove to them that I can do it, that I want to be their leader. And I know I can. I'm not going anywhere. Actually, no, it's one that I've been making a boiled fruit cake for some time, actually. I went to this friend's place for a barbecue a couple of weeks ago, and she had this beautiful recipe for this fruit cake. And I said, well, what do you put in it? So it's very similar to mine. And so anyway, I'm going to give this one a go for a change. But it was lovely.
If you're on the nets and would like to contribute to a discussion about tonight's edition of Australian Story, please go to www.abc.net.au/ausstory, except for viewers in Western Australia.